Welcome to part 3, the last part in which I am working on a track and basically going from this sound to this sound. And today we're going to master it. So the challenge for this mix fix is to only use these things as monitoring, these things. These are in-ear monitors built by Ears for You. I made a separate video on all the details of these in-ears over here. So check that out if you want to know more about it. The track that I'm going to use is a track from Juliana Wolf. It's actually already released, so if you want to listen to the full version or buy it or whatever, I'll link it underneath this video. So let's go. I want to do an analog master of the track because I think it really suits the music. So I'm going to show you how I actually do that. It's actually pretty simple. I use two channels on the console for the EQing and for the balancing. And because I'm using it on the console, it's easy to insert the tape machine as well. And I want to use the tape as an extra layer, so a parallel layer. So I can crunch it a bit more on the tape machine and then put the original one over it. And then you have the crunch version with the analog version, so without tape. And then, yeah. So I'm routing my sound to subgroup 1 and 2 for the normal and 5 and 6 for the tape machine. The tape machine is inserted in the master bus so I can control the volume towards the tape machine with this fader and from the tape machine with this fader. Yeah, let's get started. Let's first do an analog EQ and then do the tape. Now what I really like about analog gear is the openness of the highs, but we have to wait for the percussion. There it is. To really pull it open, but I don't want it to hurt my ears, so I think we're still fine. This is the difficult thing of you know, having something to listen on which you're not used to. That's cool. That's cool. Maybe this is too much. This is better. I don't want any sub lows added to it. I think it's enough. Q factor, what I'm adjusting. I think this sounds a bit sluggish. This doesn't have an effect at all. And this, so the middle Q, sounds the tightest. Strange, I don't know why, it's just like that. So this is a good basis. Now let me start the tape machine. So there's not a lot that I can adjust on the tape. I mean, it's just, you know, going through the tape and coming back from the tape again. Oh, it's really in the corner of the shot. Sorry for that. If these videos will be a success, I will buy some better mounting gear for my camera because this is a janky ass solution. Now we're starting to get to some saturation now, which I actually like. But it's a bit too much. So now I'm dragging it down just a tiny bit. It's almost impossible to see. Like that. I really like the compression on it. Yeah, I like this.
Now the thing is with tape, you have to imagine in your head how it would sound together. You cannot hear it directly together, so you have to guess. It's guesswork. And after that you can sync up both tracks, which I really like to do in Reaper, by the way, because Reaper gives you a nice overlay here on the top of on how both tracks look like. And you can really precisely, you know, get them over each other. Now, it is of course a bit difficult to sync it up. So I'm going to look at a more crowded section, how it syncs up, because actually the high frequencies are the most important to sync up, not the low frequencies. That doesn't sync. Nope. So now it's synced, you can really, really hear what it is adding with parallel tape is what I'm calling it. Of course it's a bit louder, but it's also like a bit more crunch and a bit more warmth. I like it. I think I'm keeping it like this. So the first thing I'm going to add for the mastering chain, because there still needs to be a mastering chain on top of it, and I'm doing this fully digitally. I really like to master digitally, most of all because I'm already using a lot of analog stuff in the path. I would love to have an analog mastering chain, but I would like to have a really good one. First of all, low cutting, of course. Hz, perfect. In terms of EQ, I'm not going to do a lot. I'm actually going to multiband. I'm actually EQing a lot with my multiband compressor, so. I'm using my multiband as an EQ as well. I like to have my 5 bands. That's some kind of a rule that I'm using, like subs, punch, definition, sharpness, and air. That's how I'm calling it. Maybe also, I'm just reminded of it, make the lows mono as well. So do a low cut on the sides. Something like this. Good. Now I like to compress the hell out of the sub lows, makes them really compact. Cool. That last top end. Cool, and I also have there some. And of course, ending up with a limiter to whoop this shit up, to inflate it. Not going for a lot of loudness at first. I want to know what the first response would be. When I keep the loudness low, it's actually a bit crunching in the end. Not sure if that actually happened while mixing. We'll see. Doing a small cut here, so that I can, you know, in global, all right. Now let's turn down the volume and compare. Maybe a bit less tape. I like the tape, but I'm not sure if the rest of the industry will like it. The techno niche, the people that will play the tracks and will listen to it. It's a bit analog, so it's not really clean. But it was not my point to go for clean, so that's the other side. I really wanted to go for a bit of crunchy analog sound for this, and that because I'm fully free to do what I want with the mix fix, and I really like to highlight things from a different direction. And I don't know a lot about the techno scene. I listen some techno music and I know what it's supposed to sound, and I know that this is sounding a bit different from what we're used to hearing. I don't think it's a bad thing. I'm really interested in what the reactions will be from the audience of my channel, but also from Juliane. So yeah, cool. So that's how I mastered it.
And that's it for this three-part series of the Mix Fix. Thanks a lot for watching. If you watch them all, really thanks. Let me know what you think of this in the comments below. Maybe I'll produce more of these video series. In the description below is the link to the released track, because the track is out already. So check it out down there. If you want to support me, there are several ways to do that. One of the ways is by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign. The other way is by buying a t-shirt like the one that I was wearing in all of the videos. And the last way to support me is by watching more, because in the end, the viewers is what makes a YouTube channel. So I will link one more of my videos over here. Thanks a lot for watching, keep pushing, and bye bye.